Okay, we're coming in fast, we're coming in fast. Is this thing gonna slow down? Oh, okay, it slowed down. Wow, that's actually really cool. Road trippers, you are gonna love this. We're using active cruise control, sometimes known as adaptive cruise control. Now this cool tech maintains a set distance between you and the car that's in front of you. So it makes cruise control a set and forget type of thing, because you don't have to manually adjust your speed when the car in front of you either slows down or speeds up, all right? And commuters, take note. Some systems even bring the car to a complete stop in traffic. It's simple to use too. Just turn it on using a button with this symbol on it, which is a near universal icon representing active cruise control. Now, once the system is on, just set your speed like you usually would. Now that speed will be indicated on the dash and the actual speed will be on the speedometer. Now that I have the system on, the car is in charge of its speed. So when the car in front slows down, my car slows down as well. And when that car speeds back up, my car speeds up again to whatever speed I set it in the first place. You can also adjust how closely you follow. Now I won't let you tailgate, but you can set it to be closer or farther away from the car that's in front of you. However, the closer the settings mean that the system won't react as smoothly when the lead car slows down. Like a human driver, there's less time to react, so braking can feel a little more abrupt. Many older adaptive cruise control systems shut off below 25 miles per hour or so, but most newer versions have an added feature that are smart enough to slow all the way to a stop. Known as low speed follow or stop and go, this makes active cruise control useful in heavy traffic too. To resume, just tap the gas or press the resume button. Active cruise control has actually been around on some brands since the early 2000s, but since the mid 2010s, it's made its way into more and more cars. And these days, it's often standard equipment on brand new vehicles. Now, we're just glad that this really cool road tripping tech is now more widely available. Do you have it on your car? And if so, what do you think about it? Let us know in the comments below.